r/AskReddit. Which books should a person read at least once in their life? The Man Who Mistook His Wife for a Hat by Oliver Sacks. No, seriously. It's a non-fiction journal style book about a psychiatrist, edit, neurologist, and how he dealt with the different problems, illnesses and issues, and in turn how the patients have been able to adapt and overcome the obstacles. It's very moving. Not always easy or pleasant, but powerful book. Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor Frankl. I often think of that book. What did it for me is when he talked about how some German guards were kind and some Jews were cruel. So while he saw that circumstance is what drove most people most of the time, he strongly believed that you can choose, if you try hard, to act differently than circumstances demand you act. He says it a lot better than me though. Strong to dead recommend. Man, what a duality. Seeing cruelty from those you love the most, and seeing kindness from the most heinous of villains. The Count of Monte Cristo. It is full of strong emotions, and makes you question what is justice. The Importance of Being Earnest by Oscar Wilde. Reading plays is a great experience, plus this one is hilarious. To lose one parent, Mr. Worthing, may be regarded as a misfortune. To lose both looks like carelessness. 35 is a very attractive age. London society is full of women of the very highest birth who have, of their own free choice, remained 35 for years. Catch 22. Hilarious. Depressing. Couldn't put it down. You must learn Snowden's secret. The Little Prince by Antoine de Saint-Exupéry. Very short book, but I believe everyone should read this at least once, especially adults. Every time I've read The Little Prince, I've gotten something profoundly new out of it. A masterwork. I've recommended Brave New World to everyone I know. Not only does it touch on class hierarchy, which is still present in most societies, either blatantly or subtly, but the book also delves into what happens when we strive for efficiency and forget about some of the most important aspects of what makes us human. Flowers for Algernon. A lot of us had to read the abridged version in high school. If you liked it, definitely give the full edition a try. It's worth it. I think that's part of what's stopping me from reading it. Any of the books I had to read in school, and subsequently break down and analyze like I was trying to catch a serial killer, is stuck in my brain as a horrible experience. I have no desire to go back through a book that my teachers managed to turn into such an excruciating experience. Watership Down. I fell in love with it in 6th grade and stole the teacher's copy and never gave it back. Sorry, Mrs. R. I read that copy to tatters. Have bought multiple copies and read them to tatters since. But only the brown cover with the brown bunny on front. As time goes on, they're getting harder to find. I have made just about every member of my family read it. I don't even know why I love that book so much. When I open it up and read the first line, a feeling comes over me like I am home. You might already know, but Richard Adams didn't ask me anything on Reddit, helped by his grandson. I remember when I realized that WD was him processing his experiences in WWLL, which made it all the better. In my opinion, it also got me to see religion in a different way. I'm still an atheist, but I now can appreciate faith as a positive force for people. Going to Watership Down is on my bucket list. All the World Will Be Your Enemy. Prince with 1,000 enemies. And whenever they catch you, they will kill you. But first they must catch you. Digger, listener, runner, Prince with the swift warning. Be cunning and full of tricks and your people shall never be destroyed. The Stranger by Albert Camus. The Trial by Franz Kafka. The Old Man and the Sea by Ernest Hemingway. All three tackle the struggle of a man and the society around him. Mersault in his simple otherness and detachment from those around him. Heke in his suffocation under a society and system that is other and inexplicable to him. Finally, the story of Santiago and the society that determines he has no value. Marcus Aurelius' Meditations. Begin the morning by saying to thyself, I shall meet with the busybody, the ungrateful, arrogant, deceitful, envious, unsocial. All these things happen to them by reason of their ignorance of what is good and evil. Great stuff. I cannot stress this enough. Get the Gregory Hayes translation. Fahrenheit 451. Is it similar to 1984? There are similar themes, but in 451, instead of using force and oppression to the government, seems to have weaponized distraction and entertainment, sort of like mixing 1984 with Brave New World. The Road by Cormac McCarthy. It's much better and darker than the movie. It's probably the closest imagining of what a real apocalypse would be like, with no heroes and no sense of hope. 100 Years of Solitude. It's so beautiful. I loved every page. Wherever they might be, they always remember that the past was a lie, that memory has no return, that every spring gone by could never be recovered, and that the wildest and most tenacious love was an ephemeral truth in the end. To Kill a Mockingbird. I read this book with my freshman first semester last year, and they loved it. We watched the film, which is very loyal to the book. But as soon as they noticed that part of Mayella's dialogue had been removed from the film, they were upset. I was just surprised they noticed. East of Eden? There's a coffee shop in my town called Thou Mayest. Never have I seen so many people read John Steinbeck before than when they opened. The Kite Runner by Khalid Hosseini. Battle Royale. Makes you feel sympathy for even what appears to be the most villainous and cruel person. The Giving Tree. I love this book but find it so depressing. Anyone else? The Giver. I loved this one. Read for school in 6th or 7th grade and it was amazing. I hate that it ended on a cliffhanger like a bunch of Lois Lowry's other books. All Quiet on the Western Front by Eric Remarque. Animal Farm. I read right after I finished 1984. After those two books, Orwell became one of my favorite authors. The His Dark Materials trilogy by Philip Pullman tackles issues like free will and religion, all in thrilling, fully realized fantasy world. No work of fiction has ever wrecked me as hard as the last few pages of The Amber Spyglass. My copy of the books is literally stained with tears. Lord of the Flies. It really exposes the nature of humanity, and the older you get, the more you understand. Fahrenheit 451 is also a great read. It challenges today's culture. Read it and decide for yourself. Dune series. It's glorious. Dune, at least God Emperor. Read Nothing by Brian Herbert and Kevin. I have a fetish for super weapons J. Anderson. And there is a movie coming out this year based on the first half of Dune. Knowing the source material beforehand is honestly needed. If I recall correctly, X2 men debated before whether Dune was adaptable at all, cause the book is dense and quite philosophical. Heroes are bad MK, and the Lynch Dune movie had a pamphlet that was handed out to moviegoers, so yeah. Mary Shelley's Frankenstein. There's an unending amount of lenses to analyze the text through, and you can look at so many different issues, alienation, guilt, reproduction even, while reading. Find something new to discuss or think about every time I read. Jonathan Livingston Seagull. I read it when I was 10, and it changed my life. I don't think it's unfair to call it a young adult book. It's very short, pretty simple, and has a 1960s hippie mentality, but it's also very beautiful. Have you ever felt like you're just a member of a flock, pecking out your existence among a sea of others and yearning to be something more? You don't have to settle for what the flock wants, and even if they throw you out for chasing your dreams, you can still soar. Siddhartha by Hermann Hesse. Green Eggs and Ham. Just wait until you get to the twist at the end. It's really a page-turner. Uncle Tom's Cabin by Harriet Beecher Stowe. Abraham Lincoln allegedly, upon meeting her, said, "So you're the little woman who wrote the book that started this great war. It's heart-wrenching, powerful, and eye-opening. Definitely a must-read." Umberto Eco's The Name of the Rose. It's a murder mystery set in an Italian monastery in 1327. It's dense with historical information and over 500 pages long, and yet it manages to be a page-turner for easily 80% of the book. The remaining 20% is historically interesting if you're into that kind of thing, but can be skipped without losing much in terms of the plot. I'm on my 6th or 7th reread of it right now, and it never gets old. Pride and Prejudice. The Bell Jar. The Sun Also Rises. The Stranger. They all depress the hell out of me in different ways, so they're not frequent Ray reads. Life of Pi. Never seen the movie, but the book was amazing. This'll get buried, but don't care. The Master and Margarita is a true work of art. Fascinating and tragic author history as well. The Perks of Being a Wallflower. One of those books that just captures the overall feeling of being an adolescent while also dealing with mature themes such as rape and mental health. I don't necessarily know if it belongs on this list, but I will never stop recommending Invisible Monsters by Chuck Palahniuk. There's actually a book for this question. 1000 books to read before I die. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.